What's going on, everyone? Welcome back to the channel. Today, we're gonna be doing a book summary of the Fashion Business Manual by a company called Fashionary. Before we get into it though, guys, do me a favor. Subscribe to the channel and click the bell icon so you get notifications and don't miss any of the videos. If you could like this video, that'd be fantastic. It would help the video and the channel out, and share the video as well, because that obviously massively helps me grow the channel, get in front of more people. I will leave a link to this book down in the description. So if you want to get it, use that link. It also helps the channel out. So the Fashion Business Manual by Fashionary, an absolutely phenomenal book. I am a huge fan of this company. They have an amazing style that they do their books in. They're incredibly graphical and easy to understand, easy to digest. And that's actually why I have 5 of their books in total. I have 4 more plus this one. They're really good. I'm kind of teetering on fanboy status here with the company, just because their graphic design, their book design is so phenomenal. But we're not talking about those books today, we're talking about this book. And this book is absolutely fantastic. And I picked this up sort of on a whim. I saw this on the shelf at a bookstore and I thumbed through it. I thought the design was really fun and clever, so I bought it and I couldn't be happier that I have it. Now, the front of this book says 12% branding, 24% production, 8% wholesaling, 19% marketing, 22% retailing, and 14% starting up. That's sort of the breakdown inside this book. And it's really broken down into 7 main sections. I'm gonna tell you what those are right now. They are the brand direction, product development, probably the most helpful section for me thus far, wholesaling, marketing, retailing, starting your brand, and there's a form section in the back where you have different forms that you can go through. They have like a line sheet, basic invoice, packing list, things that you can look at as you wanna, you know, if you wanna get a reference for something, and you could probably just copy them verbatim out of here. They're pretty good. Now for me, like I said, the production section has been great for starting my brand, Dapper Villains, and understanding tech sheets or the tech packs. That's one of the things I didn't know. That's probably something you learn quite a bit of, and if you go to fashion school or school for garment or accessory design, whatever, you'll learn that. I never did. I was an engineer. I did design work. I did not learn how to make tech packs at engineer school, I promise you. And so I learned a lot of that from this book, and I was able to, actually someone asked me for a tech pack, I had to look it up in the book, and then I was able to find supplemental resources so I could make it. It's not so much about the information in the book, because this isn't a book that you read cover to cover. It's not like another business book, like I reviewed 0 to 1 by Peter Thiel, which is a really pedantic startup business book. It's a fantastic book for understanding problem solution and these unique thoughts around it, but this book is so much easier to absorb because it's broken down in this really graphical way, and it's fun. Now, you're not gonna read it cover to cover. The way, at least the way I've read it, is I need to know something. I go to the index, I look it up, I go to that page, and it just got this great layout or this great infographic to explain it to me and allow me to absorb the information and then put it into action. That's the great thing about this book. It's so actionable. Every section I've gone to in this book has been super actionable, has saved me time, saved me money, and helped me get deals. The whole section on wholesaling, understanding that process from both sides, the language that's used in wholesaling, I learned all of that from this book. In the beginning sections, I've thumbed through the brand direction stuff. There is a whole section of really good business tools like SWOT analysis and building a business plan. All of that's covered in here as well. So if you need that information, you're gonna get it here. I definitely wouldn't say it's the only business book you need. I would definitely pair this with another business book though, and you would probably be 90% there. Something like the $100 Startup, which I've also reviewed before on this channel, and I'll throw a card up above there or there somewhere. I'll throw a card up above with a link to the $100 Startup, which is a fantastic business book, especially for small business entrepreneurs or micro business entrepreneurs, which I think a lot of people getting into their own brand are. And so I think that book is a good fit to sort of supplement the business side, the pure business side that this doesn't have. But from a fashion perspective, I have a lot of books about the fashion industry or this industry, the garment industry, and none of them approach the level of detail and the level of actionability, which I think is the important thing that this book has. That you can read a page, get the information, understand it easily because of the layout, and then take it and do something. I know that even Jib grabs this book from time to time, and it's very useful for her with her craft business because there's so much crossover between the two. And there's actually a section in this book about talking to potential investors. Now, having come from the startup world, I've raised quite a bit of money for companies. I've met with countless investors, and the points they give about talking to investors in here are solid. You know, it's not like some really flimsy, you know, just like one-off startup guru stuff that you would see. It's actually legit points on talking to investors. So if you do want to grow a fashion brand and grow it to a large scale, you'll need investment. There's some good points in here. You're still going to need to know quite a bit more, but these will get you started. So who is this book for? And that's a great question. It is for anyone who wants to have a business anywhere in the fashion or garment ecosystem. And again, for me, someone who didn't go to fashion school, I 1000% appreciate this book. And I think anyone who probably did go to fashion school would love this book, or anyone who went to school for garment design, accessory design. This book will still have actionable information for you. I know it's helped my brand tremendously. It's helped me run my business, design products, and understand different aspects of it. So, well worth its weight in gold to me, for sure. And I think pretty much anyone out there would love this. And also, if you're a fan of design, just in general, you love good design, these books have a phenomenal design. It is beautiful. The way they're laid out, and it's just so easy to appreciate. So if you like good design, you might just want to pick this up just to have it on the shelf and look at it from a design perspective, because it's phenomenal. Now this brand, I think they're based in Hong Kong, but you can get their books pretty much anywhere. Like I said, I'll have a link to Amazon down in the show notes for you guys. I can't recommend it highly enough, and I'll probably review at least one, if not two, of their other books in the future and do summaries of those. But just the way it's broken down, how beautiful it is, the design, highly recommend it. Check it out for sure. That's all I have for you guys today. I know it's a quick one. Until next time, keep taking action, make your ideas reality.